going on, guys? Today I'm just going to take you guys through a little bit of deadlift progress. So right here, this is about a month ago. I'm trying to deadlift 425 for a max, and I clearly failed it there because I had a terrible, terrible hitch. And then I tried it again and ended up getting it somehow with a hitch, which actually hurt my tailbone a little bit. But it's not really bothering me too much now. This is now, actually. I deadlifted 425 for like the cleanest thing of my whole life. That's actually the most weight I've deadlifted. Clearly there, I could have done like 435 or something. But I'm mostly gonna attribute that progress to block pulls. So right here, I'm doing some block pulls. This is just warming up with 135. I'm just using plates instead of the blocks I used to use because the blocks all roll around. So right here, I'm doing 225. This has actually really been helping my posterior chain grow as well. Just helping my squat. So literally it's helping pretty much all of my lifts. And one thing you do notice here that's a little different about my deadlifts is that one, I'm wearing shoes, and two, I don't have SPD knee sleeves on my shins to protect my calves. And the reason for that is I am competing in a powerlifting meet in April, so I need to wear shoes for that, for the deadlift, and I also don't think they allow SPDs on the shins to protect the shins. So yeah, I'm just trying to prepare for the meet a little bit more. Usually I do wear like soccer socks or deadlift socks when I deadlift, but I forgot them today and decided to not be a bitch and just, you know, straighten my shins up a little bit. Right here I'm doing 415 for two sets of six on block pulls. And this is actually a 10 pound PR, just getting that progressive overload from last cycle. Yeah, it's actually felt pretty damn good. I've also been screwing around with my grip a little bit just to know exactly where my hands should be. This seemed pretty good. I think my two fingers were inside the knurling. And that's my last rep. There we go. And right here I have another set of six. I've also been trying to slowly widen my stance and also just find the perfect stance for me. One thing with deadlifts that I've really been working on is getting my hips closer to the bar when I start, which was a big factor in how fast my second deadlift from before was, the 425. Oh yeah, that old guy's miring right there, saying I wish I could do that. But yeah, keeping my hips forward more actually keeps my chest more upright, my back more upright. And it also makes me drive up my legs a little bit more. So that was the block pulls for that day. This is actually, I think the day before, a few days ago, 235 on bench. I tried it and unfortunately failed. That really sucked, honestly. And right here I had 225. I tried to pause it. I just have been a little bit cocky with bench, clearly failed that again. I've just been kind of cocky with it because my bulk is finally working, and I was literally 179 the other night with clothes on, so I thought I'd be able to get that, but unfortunately I was not able to and I failed it. So right here, this is a little bit of footage from my last leg day, and yeah, I'm gonna include this and some back work, I think, from my last pull day for a little edit at the end of the video. So thank you guys very much for watching. Thank you for all the views on the transformation video and also the deadlift transformation video. I've been freaking hyped about that. I really appreciate all the support, guys. It means a lot to me. And yeah, thank you for watching. Be sure to like and subscribe, and I'll catch you guys later.